to build it for you with our steady guidance, then we go to 2.1. We start with the current flux, then we get J. We know that the current from high school I is the rate at which charge Q goes past a given point. When I say the rate, the mere mention of the rate, I mean I've already taken care of the dT. So you cannot say the rate of, and then you probably mess and say with type, no. It should be the rate already you are meaning with the time. Of course, where Q is the charge, where Q is the charge, and T is the time. I'm not going deep in the, not deep, but I'm not trying to say electricity is here, we use it everywhere. Is there anyone who wants to be told that you use electricity anymore? You charge your phone with electricity, you play your music with electricity, even your body is made up of electricity. Your sensing, if I touch something, I'm able to feel that I'm touching my box of chalk and I'm now touching my, because I have electricity, those nerves, how they are called, the one which send to my brains the information, and then my brain processes. After processing, it tells me this is this. There are people who don't have senses. There are those who have no feelings. They touch, but they don't know what they are touching. So maybe I'm touching this, maybe like a leaf. Anyone of you who has that problem? When you have a problem, sometimes you don't know. So electricity is everywhere. We use it as long as it's manufactured in Jinja, it comes all the way up to here. Some is going to be made in Karuma, and then you have other sub smaller hydropower plants. You have it in your phone, your lithium ion produces the electricity which you have stored there. And the moment you connect, the charge starts flowing and you start using it. So I'm not going to go deep into those trivials. You have to read those stuff. We are now to go to the gist of your level. Can establish that the current I is given by the charge Q, the number of charges by volume, pass through an area A, and then times the drift velocity. And thus we can find that we can establish this soon. And the charge, the unit of current would be Coulomb time, which is, per second, which would be 1 Coulomb per second. But depending, from the guy who did a lot of the experiments with the current, call it by his name, which is Ampere. Ampere. I think the E is something like an apostrophe or something like that. I don't know whether it's this E here or this one. Suppose current is being carried by consists of 10 charges.
consists of heavy charge carriers per unit volume. Drifting at a speed. VD along a constant direction,
So drifting is like, if you have seen soldiers in the pitch, if the pitch was not to be marked, and it is a huge pitch, and you make them, the band starts, and they start doing the, how do they call it, slow march. All of them, the 36, not 36, the 12, 3x4, they are always 3x4, 3x4. So they are doing their slow march, they go up, they drift at the same time. You see them, by the time if you look this way, you find that all of them are the same guys, they are at the same point. So you wonder, they come as, they drift, they do not walk. So they will just go, if my last one was there, and I am here, and I've stopped, all of us would have drifted. So that's what we call the drift velocity. So if we have n charges or charge carriers per unit volume and they are drifting at the velocity VD and they have drifted for a second, let the charge on each charge carrier be small q, so in time t, each charge carrier advances the distance from velocity is equal to distance over time. So distance will be equal to velocity equals distance over time. So distance will be equal to vt. So for our time is dt, our velocity that they are drifting with is vd, so we'll have the distance being vd dt. In this same time, dt, all charge carriers, within a cylindrical volume, if it has moved the distance vd dt, and it is in a cylindrical volume of area, and this cylinder we are taking, up is of cross-sectional area A, so we'll be having the volume being the same as VD DT, which is the distance times the cross-sectional area. We'll have passed one end of
line of Serena.
Will be the same as charge on each of the each of the charge carriers times the volume, and the volume we said is the same as ABBT. I'm not making it so direct. I could have said derive the expression for, but I made it all this to make sure that you think, you visualize. But the current I is equal to dQ by dt, and dQ by dt would be the same as QNA dV. So if we divide it by A both sides, then we would get what we call the current density. So this would imply that I over A is equal to QNVD. And then in secondly, you had this to be electron. So you must have done the derivation of like the Q here being the same as never then you were T, and I was equal to never, although this D sometimes was silent, but never. But now we chose to use any charge Q instead of insisting on the electrons. We are using the charge as the charge on the charge carriers. The charge carriers is carrying the charge small q. So this would be the current of the area of the cross section would be the same as QNVD. Thus, our J, which is equal to I over A, is the same as Q, NV, and VD. We define the current flux density current flux density vector J as the net positive charge passing through the unit area of a unit surface for a unit time. So that's how we have defined our J as the number of positive charges passing through a unit area of a unit surface per unit. Of course, our J being equal to I over A, which we have said is the same as I is equal to Q over T. So this is what we have defined in the snapshot. The elemental charge. Anything we divide by area, we normally call it flux. So that's why we are calling the Gauss's electric flux, because we are looking at the amount of field lines going through a given area of surface S. Or the elemental current, or the elemental current
years. That is a small surface. Is the eye equaling to J cos theta? Yes.
If we have any surface,
on this surface we are having a current, this is the normal, and we are having a current which is getting out of this at an angle theta, then the flux, that's where we get the flux, would be the component of the current in our surface, normal to the surface, multiplied by the area, the ds, which we are talking about. And then that's where we get the I being the same as the j. This is j. The j cos theta times. Yes. So we can now make this one look better and say by making it backwards. I would be the same as J dot. Yes. So that means if we want to get the total current, then we integrate both sides. The total current through the surface S. Through the surface S is given by I is equal to integral over the surface S J dot. Yes. Or if you want to show the normal component by using the unit direction vector, normal to the surface, we use it as integral over the surface S, J dot n root d. We shall use that several times, but the current, now we're expressing the current in terms of the surface through which it is going, and the density through that surface, and that's what we're talking about, the current density. For 2.2, we look at the current and electric charges. How do we relate the current and the charge density? And this would give us an idea of what we call the equation of state. So like we have been doing before, if we consider an adimeter volume, if we consider an adimeter volume, which we call the tau, bounded by an appearance of the surface, S and then we, this volume is having a charge density rho. would have the, this is our Bible volume. Yes. We have the fields going through it. We take an elemental surface. Here, yes. So if this is another electric field, then we have another one around here. This is our DS. If I put a vector here, it means that this is normal to that. Otherwise, our DS is equal to normal unit direction vector, then DS. Now, if this is our current density J, this is the number it makes with the surface. So we have our field line from the positive charges to negative charges, which we shall not bother according to matters to the giver and the taker. If the net charge, the statement we've made can still be described, I mean, explained by my nice abiral surface, I mean my abiral volume. So this is my volume. We can see that abiral volume tau, the everything inside here is my volume bounded by an abiral surface S. So this is my surface here. This is my surface bounding the volume which is inside here. So if I took a small part of my volume, I just take this small surface, I just take a portion of this bag of mine, and then still on that I take this small part of it, just to analyze this line of current density. So if the net charge, in other words, whatever would go in on this surface would still be the same to get out, because charge is conservative. You can neither create charge nor destroy it. And that is one of the laws that we shall utilize when we reach some part of the course to come. So if the net charge within the volume changes, then by the conservation of charge, there must be a balancing. Flow of charge. Through the surface S. So the total current I, through the surface S is given by I total current, we say our I is equal to in a broad, if it is a broad surface S, then we have our J, so yes. So if we have our volume, and after having our volume, the charge within this volume changes. It means if it has increased, it has to get up by whatever means. So, but the change in means, here you are having the charge, this charge density, this current density is just going through. So if it changes as it is going along, then you also have a balance. If it is coming in, it has to also get out. That's what we mean. If the change was coming in on the surface, that also has to allow to go out to put a balance and conserve this law of conservation of charge. Otherwise, charge is neither created nor destroyed. So this would be given by I is equal to integral over the closing surface S, bear that S. The way I write the current density, you can go ahead and put a dot and put that as well. I find it more nice than just doing this. But probably you might find you want to write it that way, put a J and then make it a rectangle. But that means you would have the I being the same as minus dQ. But if it was trying to decrease, if your current was trying to decrease, that necessitated the balance. So this would imply that the charge Q would equal to, from this one here, integral over the volume, tau over the tau. Since we are having our volume charge density here. So we can compare these two, using the volume charge density and using the definition of the current as the rate of change of the charge times time. If you are interested in scalar stuff, at the university, we add direction fields, and then we consider everything using the vector approach. So this would imply that the current I would be equal to minus dQ dt, but maybe I should but the Q is equal to integral over the volume tau or the tau. So I would be arguing that this would be minus dt, then the integral over the volume tau, rho theta, which would be the same as minus integral. I can fit this one in on the inside, and it would be partial derivative, which would be over the volume tau, kali rho by kali t, and then we have our theta. I'm just doing algebra. There's nothing much I'm going to do. So this would imply that our JWS would be the same as integral over the surface S. JWS would be equal to minus integral over the volume tau, kali rho by kali t, tau. This J, this I would be the same as this I, in which we had to substitute for Q, which is rho the tau integral. So the two I's are the same. The I with the dQ dt being the same as rho the tau, and that should also be equal to our definition of our current, which we got in terms of the electric flux density. The current flux density J, which is I equal to J dot. The two are being integrated. One is being integrated over the surface, the other over the body. Meaning that we can convert this one in. And what theorem do we use? The Gauss's divergence theorem. So by Gauss's divergence theorem, Gauss's
divergence theorem. We can convert this surface into a volume such that our integral over the surface space J dot S is the same as the integral, the divergence of J theta. So I will be able to substitute for J dot S, which will be integral divergence of J theta, integrating over the volume tau, equaling to minus integral carry rho by carry t theta over the volume tau. We are integrating over the same volume both sides. It means that something is just an instruction. So this would imply that maybe we are reading better. This would imply that the integral over the volume tau, the divergence of J plus Kali rho by Kali T over the volume tau is equal to zero. They are all integrated over the volume tau, so I can correct them to one side. Since the volume is a mirror, it couldn't be the one which is making it zero. A bit of it means that it can be any value. So if it can be any value, that means it is not the one which is causing zero. So it means therefore that our divergence of J plus Kali rho by Kali T is equal to this is called the equation of Bernoulli. The equation of Bernoulli, and it's one of the beautiful equations that are able to show how the change in the volume charge density and as the current density is going through the surface is conserved. If you change it, if you increase it, you have to allow the other charges also escape. Otherwise, you cannot yet charge nor destroy it. So if there is a lot of it coming, you have also to see it through going out of the surface. And we arrived at this since the volume tau is a bigger thing. We can cast off the integration. But if you want, you could put this statement here, and then you say we can cast off the integration. So that was the the introduction in regard to our vision or our approach of current electricity or our steady currents at this level, where the word steady state, you will find that the steady state, this one will be the same as the steady state equation, whereby you are having a balance of the change of the charges plus the current density, the divergence of the current density, how they are busy going through, there should be a balance. As you change the charge density, there should be a balance, always having the flow of the current density getting out of your volume. So let's now look at the
what most of you are used to. You make tea every morning. You do the ironing every morning because you have power delivered into your flat iron
or the coil of anyone of you who still uses suicide
to make tea or whatever. Do you know suicide? Not the one of hanging yourself.
Suicide, you by all means, you give any two medals, whether there are some scraps and good wires on them, and then you put the stuff in the water, and then you start boiling the water. Or you get an old coil which is spoiled, you just put a wire here and a wire, and you dip in your jar. And when it starts boiling, you know you are going to make your bush. That is suicide. It is suicide because any mistake, you are a dead body. That's why they used to call it suicide.
So we go to 2.3, electrical power. Delivered. The Lord. It's kind of disoriented. I should have first generated this power and then later on give it to the Lord. But I'll start with the power that I can deliver to the Lord. So the moment I have a battery with a positive and a negative, whether it is by any type of the battery you got, it's believed that the chemical process has taken place in your body, eventually produce the electricity. And that electricity, you can use it to do many things. You can use it to produce sound. For example, I connect my speaker to my music system with a couple of other components. And then I'm able to dance around. I can connect it to a monitor and I'm able to watch a nice movie or TV. But I'll still have other effects. Your TV will heat up, your radio will heat up at one point, but that was not the purpose you were supplying power for it, compared to when you decide you want to iron. When you are ironing, you know you are dealing with heat. You are expending some heat and you are utilizing it. It should have just been expended after being heated up. But you utilize it, you expend it within your clothes so that you can make them, like for mine, I don't see whether I did it. But maybe the trouser I did of it. You want to make it smooth, but by making sure that you utilize this power which is being expended to iron your stuff. These lamps will not have any heat in it, even if you held it, because this is not a heating element. You got electrons at the cathode, I don't know which one is which, and then they get attracted by the anode. In the process, there is a gas in between here. That gas is ionized, it glows. The glowing is amplified by the fluorescent material within the walls of the fluorescent tube. So this one doesn't heat up. That's why when you're in a room with the tubes, you actually feel cold, like when you're in the library, compared to when you are in a room where there are incandescent bulbs. You still use these bulbs? In the lab, these bulbs here. So these bulbs you have, this one is heated up, it glows. Also, if you have the bulbs which have that whitish thing, you still got the, some have a fluorescent material put, others have carbon, xenon or krypton, in order to be able, or neon, any inert gas to make sure that you avoid the corrosion of this to make sure it is always nice, and also to increase on the produced glow. So that means when this chemical is trying to produce
is done. So that's why we shall be talking of the work, the power, and the energy. After all, you call maybe power that power has charged. Others say kara has charged.
Meaning, I guess, kara, isn't it?
Is kara, when you say kara has charged, you mean kara? Like last Friday, kara charged. Power went. We said power has gone. We don't hassle to say electricity has, because we are interested in its usability, which is the power. So we consider some source. We consider some source of electrical energy. E.g. a barrel or an electric generator connected across the road, connected across the road. So load here has got a lot of meanings. In the high school, in primary, you had the load, the effort, and the fulcrum. So you were looking at stones in a wheelbarrow as your load, the tire being the fulcrum, and where you are holding us. But the Lord here, we meet the Lord, anything that you can connect to consume your. My machine, its circuitry is the Lord, is the one which is consuming the barrel that it uses. My camera uses the barrel. That barrel, the camera now itself, it's working, it becomes the Lord. If I have a generator, then I connect on the lights, I put on the load. So the load is anything that you are putting on your source of electrical energy. So I got a generator or a battery as a source. Then I have the load, which can be any resistor, the filament of the bulb, could be the volume of the radio. So these are my two points, A and B, across the load. Then I will have the potential difference, VBA, across my load. So this is the load. Suppose the source remains the potential difference VBA equaling to VA minus VB across the load. Resulting in a current I through the load. At high potential. All the circuits you find in physics, in electricity and electronics, the upper part is always at a higher potential. But we still say that when VA is greater than VB,
we say that the conventional current N as an A. And leaves through B. That is because I'm going to put random polarity here. But by what we assume VA is greater than VB, then we would be able to say that the electrons move up here from B to A. If this is positive, that is what we mean by high potential. That means the current is this is at high potential, then the electrons will be moving up here. From B to A. Now they are up there. I'm having a lot of words so that you are able to read through, come up with and understand the genesis of what we are trying to work for. So the amount of work done by the source to transfer charge, by the source to transfer charge dQ through the load. The VBA and then dQ, I is equal to dQ dt, so dQ would equal to I dt. At a given instant, the instantaneous power delivered to the load is P is equal to the rate of doing the work, which will be equal to I dVA, and the work done transfer charge through the load for a time t. Is given by the work done is equal to the integral from time 0 to t p dt, which will be equal to the integral from 0 to t iv dt. And the units of power, the units of B this power be ampere volts, where 1 ampere volt is the same as 1 coulomb per second joule per coulomb, which is equal to 1 joule per second, which is the same as 1 watt. So the unit of power is 1 watt. I hope I'm not making things complex. This was just power delivered to NLO. We are not segregated. But 2.4.1, we look at the power delivered to an ohmic circuit element.
Which is simply abbreviated as double K. carpet.
Electrical work done by the source. In the time T, is given by work done is equal to I V T, which is the same as V squared over R T, and is made up of joules.
Who knows the other names of joule? Joule, their family owned a brewery. So after all his sweating and being hot as he's brewing the beer, he started working on how he can get the quantities of this heat he's suffering with. So that's why we normally say these are joules, especially when we talk of heat being the same as joules. Now here, this heat, this power here is normally expanded as heat, and this heat here is what is normally avoided when power, for example, is transferred from ginger to Kampala or any other place. You have to use from Ohm's law that resistance is proportional to the length of the conductor, resistance being proportional to the inverse of the cross-sectional area, or being inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area. Then this one can amount in rho R proportional to L over L, and R being the same as rho L over, where this one is resistivity. But before I even go down to resistivity, this one alone shows you that if you have huge wires, huge cable, huge cross-sectional area cables, and then you are having them as long as you can, then you are able to reduce the resistance. So there are two things which are done when power is being transferred from ginger to Kampala. One, you must make sure that the voltage is high, this VP, the voltage at the secondary of the transformers in ginger is high compared to the primary. And this would actually help in making sure that it is the reverse in the current. So you increase the voltage at ginger equivalent in the same ratio the transformers at ginger will reduce the current. When they reduce the current, that means here you are reducing significantly the I squared for heating. So you will have no loss of heating, and also you make those cables thick. That's why when you look at the high power tension cables, they are huge. Otherwise, they would save and just use like one wire. But you find the wires which are, these aluminum wires, which are used for making hangers, those who steal them and make hangers, it is huge. You find that it is some size. And then you have many of them stranded together. And then you have, again, inside, those of steel also, which are stranded there. So the total, you find, is a very nice, huge thing. This is to increase this one here, so that this equation here is small. So when you increase this, you reduce the resistance. And also, because this length is also, the longer it is, the more the resistance, they keep making them have stopovers. So you have between these two crossarms on the poles, you have this wire stopping here, and then you have a jumper to make sure you have continuity, but the jumper is not as big as the other part. So you keep having those jumpers for that short distance, in order to make sure that you counter this. So when they are, what you study here is also, this in the mind, an engineer would know these cables have to be huge. So when you are procuring, you have to procure big cables to make sure that your cross-sectional area is big, you reduce the resistance. The shorter the wires are, the better, because you also reduce, since the resistance is proportional to it.
So we did, and also with the huge stepper that is done at Jinja
is done on the voltage, because when you do it on the voltage, equivalently you reduce the current. So the current is, the more voltage you raise, the more the current goes down. And then when you reach around here, you need, you've seen or you've heard of some of the localities where they say our transformer knocked, or they say we haven't gotten a transformer, that's why our power is fluctuating. Because when you make it come here, you must make sure that you again reduce the voltage to increase the current that is useful to our equipments at home, and then be able to use it. It is advisable, for example, when you are trying to, for example, if you want to use power banks, like you want to use solar energy, keep the batteries, charge up the batteries, the solar batteries, and use the power. It's advisable you use huge wires. If you use small wires, and if anyone of you has ever tried to jump start the car, and then you use small wires, nothing happens. Then when you touch the wires, you find they are hot. So it's advisable to get like a spanner, the two spanners, and you put on the battery, and you start comfortable, and the spanners will be as cold as ice compared to this, you know, these fake wires they sell on the road, which are small. You start, that current goes through, and most of your power will be lost as heat due to high squared R. You have the high current from the battery charge, from the battery you are using to jumpstart. You have small wires, so the cross-sectional area is very small, the resistance is high, the power dispersion becomes high, and then you become hot or warm, whatever you want to call it. Knowing this expression here, whereby this can be interpreted as being 1/r, the conductivity. Next, on Friday, we will be able to look at, use a microscope and look at this equation better, and that will help us go to what we call the microscopic form. Ohm's law. And then once we have gone into the microscopic form of Ohm's law, then I'll be able to now tell you what happens within a conductor. How do the atoms with their electrons spinning around the shells, with their protons also moving within, how does conduction take place? When you hook my left part, if I'm the conductor, my arms were a conductor, assume this is not there, these arms are conductor. When you hook the current from here to here, we would like to know what happens inside that makes the current flow from this side to this side. What takes place inside? And then we shall come up with the things to do with the tau, which will get a new name as a relaxation time. And then we shall also look at conductivity, and then get a relationship between the current density, the conductivity, and the relaxation time. Relaxation time is the time between any two successive collisions. As you hook this part on the voltage, and this other part, electrons start flowing. So they will know. The reason you have the wires heating up is because you are having electrons knocking ferroelectrons, knocking atoms, knocking the nucleus. And that's why if you were to, you can do an experiment. If you have a skill of chipping your hands, if you do it, if you can try to do it, those who are interested in passing this course. And you tell me what you are feeling. Just chip, don't do this, just chip. Make sure it just slices on. What do you feel? If you are not doing this, you fail the course. I'm not seeing you, but... What do you feel? You feel the heat because you are having this hand releasing its kinetic energy to this other hand. If I lift one hand just static, you will feel that the one which chips, the other one feels the heat more than the one which came. So this one loses the heat. But imagine that instant, you are able to feel that heat. And imagine when you have these electrons having been now made to move across the conductor, they go heating. So they lose their kinetic energy, which is changed into heat. That's why when I get a nail, and I put it on a flame. Is it a flame? Then the electrons start moving. They start knocking each other. If I keep it there for a long time, they will knock each other, knock them uselessly or senselessly. Until when they just knock off. They start, you know, they knock each other, they lose the sense of direction, start falling over, then you see my metal being melting off. You see becoming a liquid. Because they have knocked each other, they don't even know where they are going, and then you get a metal melting. The one of chemistry must be known now. So the atoms just, atoms, electrons, they fall off, and then you have a molten star. It's until when you leave that molten star to cool up, and when it cools up, then you metal again. When they have come back and said, we are back here. So we shall get more of that. When we meet on Friday.